Did you ever imagine when you started out that rap would be the subject of a, scholarly anthology?
Wow, of course, we all get into things that we get into when we're young and at an early age in our lives. But I actually had vision, and I saw this thing actually spreading around the country
Really, I mean, early
and
on.
spreading around the world because I saw it as something that was really malleable,
Yeah.
if you want to, if you want the, no pun intended, but you could shape hip hop or rap into any form and come up with all kinds of styles, the different kinds of so much variety in it. I just knew that it was going to spread and it was going to be big.
Did you think of yourself? I mean, I'm asking this because this book is sort of presenting rap as lyric poetry.
Oh,
Now,
yes.
did you think of yourself as a poet?
Of course,
You did.
yes, definitely. And we write our raps with meters, and in poetry you have to have a meter. Your AB, your BB, and then you repeat these meters when you continue your rap as you are writing. So the rhythm, or we call it the flow, is so very, very important. But it's just like poetry, and it actually is one of my definitions for rap. The rap is simply poetry in motion.
Poetry in motion. Now, you've seen a lot of things happen to the music and to rap over several decades. A lot of commercialization, focus on some violence, things that became very controversial, misogyny, treatment of women. Has any of that worried you from where you started to where things are today?
Sort of in the early days when it first came around and the style started to change and people were getting you what I call, we were evolving from going from the early days where it was mostly party and have a good time or some kind of message that we were trying to deliver. And then it got harder and harder.
But so where are we today? I mean, in terms of the music, in terms of rap, have things come around in a way that you're happy or satisfied with?
Well, it's pretty much the same as it was when it was changing. I sort of think of it as a spiritual situation where God created hip hop, and then the devil tries to get in and destroy it and make it dark. And this is what we are witnessing now, the darkness of it. But there are a few of us left that are in the light, and we are trying to represent the, I wouldn't say good hip hop, but just a balance, something of a balance. I'm one of the cats who have recorded over 250 rap songs and never used profanity. And I look forward to recording again and keeping that record straight. So, there's a balance. There are a few cats out there who we call them conscious rappers, like Common. You interviewed him, and also Talib Kweli and people like Nas. And there are a few cats out there who are trying to keep the history correct and the actual culture alive, and trying to keep it a nice balance.
Thanks so much for talking to us.
You're welcome.
Okay.
Peace.